Amen. Okay, thank you. Sorry about that. I had Sister Jessica help me with something real quick. Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. All right. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. I would like to welcome you all to God's Power and Deliverance Ministries. Everyone, be seated. Thank you. All right. This morning, I would like to say, faith. Now, faith is like seeing it rain on a cloudy day in spite of the stormy weather. There always comes a beautiful sunny day. But when my faith was weak, I asked God, is there more to life than just to struggle, than die? He said, I shall surely bless those who are willing to try. Then I asked, what does that mean? God said, keep me first and thou shalt conquer thy dream. I asked God, what should I do? Those who endure to the end are just a few. He continued, a man cannot possibly understand how much I care in the midst of hardship and grief. I am always there. Finally, God said, no matter how difficult life gets, faith is key. You shall overcome if you keep believing in me. Amen. And the point of reference to that in the scripture is Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance of all things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Amen. And that's Hebrews 11:1. Amen. And I welcome you all again to God's Power and Deliverance Ministries, where our shepherd is Bishop Derek L. McClendon. Amen. And our elect lady is Elder Patrice McClendon. Amen. And I hope that you guys are ready for a word today.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for that welcome. Amen. As well as scripture reading. Amen. At this time, we're going to have words of encouragement, followed by announcement and seed time. Minister Candace is coming forth with words of encouragement, and then Mother Bridges will do our announcements as well as seed time. Amen.
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 Okay, there's two scriptures. Thank God for the opportunity to speak before his people. And I thank my leaders for listening to God and believing in me. Amen. Amen. So the scripture that I wanted to come off of was Philippians 1:6. And it says, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. And I say that to say, don't doubt what God can do for you. You have to be confident. You have to have the confidence to go forth. If he told you to do something, do it. It might be rocky at first, but don't give up. Because if you give up, then you know you'll never accomplish it. But at least if you keep going and you keep trying through your mind battles, through what you think people think about you, that shouldn't even matter. So you have to have more confidence than you have fear. Because like Elder McClendon said, it don't work. Fear and faith can't mix. So if I could be encouraging to you all, is to continue to do, is to be confident that God is going to perform that good work in you. And if I could tell a testimony, I can tell one about my job. I'm here in praise team, but I know right now it's like on my job, Bishop said that I was going to be promoted because God told him that he saw promotion in my future. And I'm like, God had told me that a long time ago, but it never happened. So I'm like, it's not going to happen. And then Bishop said, and I'm like, but God, nothing has happened. So when is this going to take place? Because I don't see it happening right now. And then probably like 2 months later, the operator that I was there on the Chick-fil-A that I worked for, it was like, I'm retiring at the end of the month. So now that corporate has taken over, they were looking at me this whole time. The managers were looking at me and was like, push your name forward. And even the store manager, and he's like, Javari, I'll mention your name to be in leadership here at the job. And so what he saw was not wrong, and what God told me was not wrong. I just didn't have the confidence that it was going to happen. Or even the faith, your walk with God. Sometimes God's going to say, you're going to do this certain thing, but then you allow what people say, you allow fear, you allow the enemy to attack your mind, but you got to tell the enemy, you ain't nothing but the father of lies. And if the Bible consider the devil the father of lies, you know that anything he say is not true. It's not going to come to pass. And I even had to tell that, I had to say that the other day. I was like, you the father of lies. You come to steal, kill, and destroy. You don't come to bring forth life. But God come to bring life and life more abundantly. God come that I may have everlasting life. He loves me. He is love. He didn't give me a spirit of fear, but he gave me power, love, and a sound mind. So I don't even have to battle with you right now, because I know that battle don't even belong to me, but it belongs to God. This is a thousand centuries, millions of year old battle that ain't got nothing to do with me. I'm just in the crossfire, but I will step forth and do what God want me to do and what he have me to do, because I believe that whatever he has planned for me, it shall be, because he's not a man that he shall lie. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Awesome words of encouragement this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, God's Power and Deliverance Ministries. I'm here to bring the announcement. The prayer line will be held on Tuesday, November 2nd, beginning at 7:30 p.m. And the Elder Bannister is our prayer host warrior. The prayer line number is 302-202-1104. Again, that number is 302-202-1104. And the access code to get on the line is 223-291. That's 223-291. Please join us live on Facebook on Sunday mornings at 10:30 for our Sunday morning worship service. Zoom Bible study is every Wednesday night at 7:30. The Zoom meeting number is 912-0853-375. That's 912-0853-375. And the passcode is all caps, GPDM13. That's GPDM13. The outreach ministry will be conducting a canned food drive for those less fortunate from Saturday, October the 23rd to November the 12th, 2021. Donations can be given to Missionary Jackson, Deacon Roger Dawkins, and Sister Jessica Bridges. The Winter Crusade at Fort Tabernacle by Grace, located at 419 Macduff Avenue in South Jacksonville, Florida. That zip code, that's 49419 Macduff Avenue South. That's in Jacksonville, Florida. And the zip code is 32254, where Apostle Michael Walker Sr. is a pastor. Dates are Friday, December the 10th, at 7:30 p.m., Saturday, December the 11th, at 7 o'clock p.m., and Sunday, December the 12th, at 11 a.m. The speakers are going to be Apostle Michael Walker, Bishop Derek McClendon, and Elder James Robinson. Please see Sister Jessica as soon as possible for hotels, accommodations, if you wish to go on this trip. We want to say for the very last time, happy birthday and anniversary to those celebrating in the month of October. That's for this year, y'all, not forever, but for this year. Seed time. It's now seed time in God's ministry. I will be reading scriptures of Malachi 3:8-12 and 2 Corinthians 9:6-7. And Malachi 3:8-12 reads, "Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground. Neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, said the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, and you shall be a delightsome land, said the Lord of hosts." 2 Corinthians 9:6-7 reads, "But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Every man according as he purposes in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. If anyone needs a tithe and offering envelope, please raise your hand and David will bring it to you."
Take it to him, David.
Amen.
Thank you.
I do want to say the Cash App again is $GPD13. And I also miss Pastoral Love Offering. This is from Bishop McClendon. Pastoral Love Offering is $25 monthly. His Cash App is 706-306-3133. Again, that Pastoral Love Offering of $25 a month, and Bishop McClendon's Cash App is 706-306-3133. And the Church App, again, is $GPDM13. Thank you. I'm going to turn the service back over to Elder McClendon.
Amen. Thank God for Mother Bridges for those announcements as well as seed time. Amen. Holding our envelopes or our offerings up in the air. Amen. As we decree and declare over our seed, Father,
it's not a debt we owe.
It's not a debt we owe. Nor, but a seed we sow.
But a seed we sow.
We're sowing for good health.
We're sowing for good health.
Well.
Minds to be made free.
Souls to be saved.
And
for our new church building. And as we sow this seed. Onto good ground.
We say grow seed.
We'll see you later. Amen. Come and give it with an expectation.
Celebrate another day of living. I just want to celebrate another day of life. Put my faith in the people that let me down.
Amen. If everyone's obeyed God in the giving here as well as on Facebook Live. Again, as Mother Bridges has stated, the Facebook Cash App is $GPDM13. Amen. And if you're paying a pastoral love offering for the month, it is his bishop's cell phone number, which is 706-306-3133. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we're going to have Devin to bless the offering. Amen. Did you hear hallelujah come out of his mouth? Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we ask you to bless this offering, Lord God. Father, we ask you to use it, Lord God, for the upbuilding and upgrading of your kingdom, Father God. Bless those who gave. Bless those who wanted to give but didn't have the means that they will be able to give on next time. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Thanking you, Father. Amen. Amen. Come on, give it up for your giving this morning. Amen. 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 I can't emphasize it enough. Amen. Put a knee on your feet. Amen. For he loves a cheerful giver. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to go ahead and go forth with our service. How many is ready for a word on this morning?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God for the word that's going to come forth. Amen. We ask God to preach him and lead him. Amen. And to order his steps as he bring us a word from on high this morning. But right before he comes up, we're going to have one of the spiritual daughters, amen, Sister Cleo, to come forth and introduce our bishop this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. They say, stay ready, you ain't got to get ready, right? But that's easy for me to introduce this speaker. He is a spiritual father. He is the shepherd of this house. He is one of my kids' favorites, of course, next to Elect Lady. Sadly, he's second to Elect Lady. But he is a great spiritual father. He is someone that you can definitely call for wisdom. I am a single woman, so anything financial-wise going into God is eventually going to bless me into my home. That's who I call. He is a great leader. I thank God for him. I thank God for his leadership, not just being the shepherd over this place, but of the county schools. Amen.
Amen.
So God didn't bless him just to be our shepherd, but to be a police officer. He's a great man of God, and God truly does speak to him. So everybody, if you could just stand up and get ready for this word, because I know God is going to deliver a word, not just to you, but also to me. Presenting to some and to others, Bishop Derek L. McClendon.
Amen.
Amen.
She wrote a biography. But your life speaks volumes when someone can speak of you that way. Amen. So we appreciate Sister Cleo. Amen. Somebody text and call Jared and tell him, do not call me at 11:52. P.M. That Jared, I tell you. Then text and call 11:52. They quiet had sense enough to do it during the day. Jared said himself, I'm just going to wake him up. But I thank God because they deal with a lot of grown folk don't do. They let their leader know they were going to be out. And I respect that. That's coming out of teenagers, amen?
Amen.
Let's give God a good hand and clap of praise.
Amen.
Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. So good to see Brother Thomas, Sister Thomas back in the house, along with their children, amen? I believe God is going to do something for them miraculously. But we gotta believe God, amen? Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. Lift those hands. Come on, let's just worship him. Come on. Somebody say, bless the Thomas family. Somebody say, yeah, bless your family. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say, Lord, bless your family. Well, who is the last family? That's all of us. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Wonderful Savior. And it's because you sought the wisdom.
If I were an eagle,
God's ever bring peace in the land.
I would use my wings.
because you sought the wisdom. God said, I'm going to bring peace in the matter. Somebody say peace.
Peace.
Be still.
Be still.
In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to your name, Master. I want you to get your pens and papers out today because we're going to go to school. Amen. Somebody say it's school time. Oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I'm going to minister a message today. You can take your seats. I won't be long. Glory to God. We got to get Pastor Morris on in here. Amen. So I'm going to give you a shorty but a quickie. Amen. But when I put you with this gut shot, amen, we're going to take you down. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So good to see Elder Ballast in the house. Amen. I see you, Elder. Come on, let's give her a hand clap. And I'm talking about senior age. I'm talking about senior elder in position. Amen. Amen. That girl looked at me like, who he calling senior? Amen. Amen. We thank God for her being in the house. Amen. Glory to God and everybody else under the umbrella, amen, of this great ministry. Amen. And soon to be all over the world.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your holy name. Real quick, hallelujah. I'm going to minister a message to them, Jessica, if you let me. Glory to God. Come on, control your narrative. Come on, somebody. I'm going to say that one more time because Sister Tammy is in here. Glory to God. She's an educator, so I know. She's checking to see if Bishop going to dot every I and cross every T. That's how the educators do it, amen. They're looking for every blue, every blood, though. So they're going to let you know, brother, wait a minute, you should have put a period or a comma there. Well, guess what? I'm going to let go so God can do what? Control this narrative. I'm going to say it one more time. You got to control your narrative. Now watch this, Cleo. The word narrative is defined as a spoken or written account of connected events or a story. Let me say it one more time. Brother Thomas didn't catch that one. Your narrative, Brother Thomas, says what you've been through since you, glory to God, came out your mother's womb, if you will. Your narrative is a spoken or written account, hallelujah, James, of connected events or a story, glory to God, that you only can tell. There's some things in your narrative that some people don't know. The molestation that you went through, come on, the rape that you went through. Oh, come on, I'm talking to somebody today. You went through some things where you could have smoked a joint, they could have laced it with some, come on, some cocaine. You could have became a crack addict. But God is there, come on, to control your narrative. Your narrative is your life
story.
Amen.
Does that make sense today?
Yes.
Can I teach this word? We know that, glory to God, that we had great storytellers, like the great Steven Spielberg. You know, he wrote E.T. and Jaws. Some of y'all don't catch that because you weren't even born at that time. Hallelujah. Then we got the great, one of my great storytellers is Francis Ford Coppola. He wrote the movie The Godfather, if you will, glory to God. Some of y'all my age remember The Godfather. But the story that I'm talking about in the narrative I'm talking about is written by the most great prolific writers in the world. What's his name? His name is our Father, come on, which art in heaven, that controls your narrative. But you got to be the co-director to write the script.
Come on.
Talking about control your narrative. Can I teach this today? I don't want to preach it. Can I teach it? Somebody said, teach, Bishop.
Teach,
I want you to know, get your pen and paper out. You got to take notes when the teacher is teaching. I want you to know that there are four types of narratives. Somebody say, teach, Bishop. Number one, there's a linear narrative. L-I-N-E-A-R narrative. What's that, preacher? A linear narrative presents the events of the story in the order in the actual the way it happened. This can be accomplished through a narrative perspective, if you will, but being the first person narration, the second person narration, or the third narration. That's the linear narrative. The second, somebody say number two, is a non-linear narrative. What's that, Shawnee? We in school, a non-linear narrative represents the events of the story out of order. Come on, somebody. The story out of order implies flashbacks, talking about what was and what is of your past. And other liturgy devices, it shifts the chronological of your story. In other words, Janice, what was then, and what's to come is going to happen. Say amen unto me. And come on, somebody say number three.
Number three,
I'm so glad you asked today, Felicia. It's the quest narrative. The quest narrative is a story in which a protagonist works tirelessly towards a goal. I may have said that word wrong, but you can get it. Just look it up. Hallelujah. The pursuit of the goal likely becomes all-consuming passion. This is when you write in that book and you want to tell your story, but you're putting some oomph, if you will, in it. You want to put some creativity in your narrative, if you will. But the word says quest narrative must face seemingly insurmountable obstacles along the way.
That means all the hell you've been through. That rocky road you've been through.
Yes.
Have I got a witness in here today?
Yes.
Can say, I done been through some things,
yes.
Amen, that I just can't explain.
Amen.
But see, that's that quest you want to, yes. Candace, you're on a journey.
Yes.
Hallelujah. See, you can quest for something. It means you're looking for something. And that's that rocky road that you may go up that mountain. But when you're going up that mountain, there's some steeps, there's some slopes.
Right.
If you will, there's some rocks that can fall off that mountain. But God brought you through.
Yes.
Janice, this is why you got to learn how to control your narrative.
Yes.
Well, let me give you the hint. How do I control my narrative? In all thy ways. That's a secret.
Hallelujah. The fourth is the viewpoint narrative. What's that, Bishop? Somebody say, what's that?
What's that?
The viewpoint narrative is designed to express the points of view of the subjective personal experience.
See, that's your story. Your personal experience, Brother Thomas, what you had to deal with. Because I don't know your story unless God reveals it to me. Only you know it. And the only way you can tell me your story, Brother Thomas, is you got to get up here and testify. What you mean testify, Bishop? Whatever you've been through, all the hell you caught, amen, even the good, the bad, and the ugly,
you got to be able to testify. In other words, you got to have a test. To have a testimony. Somebody reading their words. Come on, say amen. The viewpoint narrative, hallelujah, is a personal experience, a main character. Somebody say me.
Me.
Say I'm the main character.
Main character.
Or other fictional characters in the story. Listen, out of four of these narratives, Jessica, out of all four of these narratives, I do believe that the best one fits you is the Lydia. Why is that, preacher? Because it allows you to, hallelujah, present the events of your story in the order in which they actually happen. See, you only know that. And if your narrative is not a lie, let me back up, rewind. If your narrative is not a lie, come on, you know you want to testify about what somebody else done or what you heard. You know you got them paper thugs, hallelujah, talking about they've been in jail. Nah, Negro, we was in jail for 2 hot days. We talking about somebody that's a convict that's been there over 5 years. You were convicted felons. I ain't talking about that 30-day traffic ticket. So you can't lie about, come on, your story, your narrative, if you will. Come on and shake amen unto me. See, if your narrative is not a lie, not lying, then you must be telling them, come on, the John Brown truth. To the book of St. John, beloved.
St. John 8:32. And when you have it, say, I have it. Wonderful Savior. Come on, somebody, he's the Prince of Peace.
Amen.
Somebody say, he's the King of Kings.
He's the King of Kings.
Glory, Master Jesus. Come on, I need a praying church.
Amen.
Whoever get it first, read it. Talking about control your narrative. See, you must be, you better tell the truth about your narrative. For somebody to be delivered, Sister Tammy, you got to tell the truth.
Amen.
Free.
So what does it say?
And ye shall know the truth.
And ye shall what?
Know the truth.
Now, shall is a promise. Shall is a promise. And ye shall, talking about you, shall do what?
Know the truth.
And you shall know the truth.
And the truth shall make you free.
No, 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 no. You tell them a lie. Because everybody say it make you. It do what?
Make you free.
No, they always say set. You teach, talk to me. Let me know now what the word say. What does it say, Sister Terry?
It says make you free.
No, well, why they always say it's set? Huh? Because that's what you heard. The preacher get up there, he get fired up. Brother Tom, I heard that the truth will set you free. Ain't he all right? You done missed out on the whole word because it don't say that.
Amen.
This is why you got to study to show thyself. You got to check behind your most favorite preacher in this hour.
Come on.
What a man may be today, he may not be tomorrow.
Come on.
So one word, Shawty, can mess up a whole generation. Look how we've been sitting there quoting that word for years because mama them said it.
Mm-hmm.
Aunt Cat them said it. Rem Pigfoot said it. Huh? And it's just set you free.
Mm.
It don't set you free.
It makes you free.
Because everything you can set loose, you can recapture.
Amen.
You tell a lie, you can bring it on back.
Mm-hmm.
And tell some more lies.
Mm.
Fanny flies eating pies. Waiting on the sweet by and by.
Jesus.
You a deliverance church. Whatever you've been through, all the hell you've been through, that's your narrative.
Yes, Lord.
But you got to learn how to control your narrative. All Somebody right. say, control my narrative.
Control my narrative.
St. John, read it again. St. John 8:32, what does it say?
And ye shall know the truth.
And ye shall know the truth. Somebody say your narrative.
Your narrative.
That's the truth of what happened to you. That's your personal experience, Felicia. I don't know everything you've been through unless God reveal it.
Amen.
Mm. I don't want to be a lying prophet. God has never lied to me. So a lot of times if I don't prophesy because he ain't gave it. A lot of people run to the church. When me and my wife first started the ministry, we pack it out. Because they want to hear what the brother going to prophesy. She had an auntie, she say, is all he do is prophesy? My wife said, no, he preach. But wherever God has me, that's where I'm going. Say amen.
Because
somebody need to be delivered. And God has let me read. Ooh, he's let me read there. He's let me see all the hell you've been through and the lies and the persecution, if you will. He's let me know that you've been to hell and back. He's let me know that when you was 3 years old, your mama was on food stamps and your daddy went upside the head. He tells me these things.
Yes, Lord.
Because I spent a little time with him.
Mm-hmm.
But then I've been to hell and back, so who you think he going to use?
Oh my God.
Somebody that he put in the dungeon. At the age of 15, selling crack cocaine.
My God.
Putting pistols on people's head, Brother Thomas. That's what I did. But that's my testimony.
Amen.
Had to sit in that juvenile detention. See? Mm-hmm. With thugs, murders, rapists, and robbers. See?
Amen.
That's my narrative. And shortly, I didn't take control of my narrative because I didn't know how to take control.
Mm-hmm.
But then God give you leaders to show you how to take control of your narrative. That's like me giving glory to God by Camille a loaded shotgun and say, go out there and shoot it. She going to kill everybody.
Well, God.
But she let her spiritual father come and say, no, baby, we're going to load it like this. We're going to aim it like this. And you going to look down that front side. If it's brewery, that means you're on your target.
Amen.
See? Her daddy had to show her. And now I can let her loose. I can trust her with trouble. Because the narrative now is being revealed. That means I was a co-director in her life. Why? Because I helped write that
story. That narrative.
That narrative.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
St. John 8:32 says what?
And ye shall know the truth.
Uh-huh.
And the truth shall make you free.
Wait a minute. And ye shall know
the truth.
Uh-huh. And it do
and,
what?
And the truth shall
shall is a promise from God. In other words, when you find out the truth, you should be free from the stupidity that you did. Oh, you come on, talk
come
to
on.
Me.
Amen.
All the bad decisions you made.
Yes.
Huh?
Amen.
You should be made free from all that stuff. Now I know the truth.
Amen.
Who the Son has set free,
it's free.
Who he made. Is free in deed. Come on. Have I got to witness God's power? Watch this word. Can I preach for a second?
Okay.
Nah, I'm gonna teach this. You got to control your narrative and don't judge yourself by your past. Who am I minister to right now? Let me say that again. Minister, I may be talking to you. Back down memory lane. You can't go back down memory lane because what Calvin did to you. You know why you can't get ahead in your new relationship? Jesus, you can't get ahead because you think about what was with Calvin did, and here come Tony. God got him looking like a muscle machine. He loves the Lord. He ain't trying to go inside your head or cheat on you or take what you got from your children. He's trying to be a man of God, but you still talking about what Calvin did. And God told you, I'm giving you something new, but you can't control your narrative because you're upset with your past.
Oh, God. Jesus.
I'm talking to somebody. Control your narrative so you don't judge yourself. Stop beating yourself up by your past, glory to God. Why? Because you don't live in your past anymore. Come on and say amen unto me. Somebody get Isaiah the 43rd chapter real quick. Hallelujah. Isaiah 43 and 18. Come on, y'all. I'm moving quick. I got to get out of here. Come on. Isaiah the 43rd chapter. Glory to God. Verse 18. I'm talking about it. Don't live in your past anymore. You got to say, I got it. Hallelujah. Isaiah the 43rd chapter. Verse 18. I'm talking about control
your narrative.
Your narrative. What does it say?
Remember not the former thing.
Yeah. Wait.
Uh-oh.
God just gave you a duty and a commandment. And you wonder why you being. Come here, Sister Tammy, real quick. Let me use you. Brother Thomas, can I use your wife real quick? I don't want to touch her without your permission. Can I use your wife? Thank you, sir. Hallelujah. That's decency and order. Somebody say decency and order. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory. Now, you didn't know Brother Thomas back in the days. See? A little bit. He wasn't your first boyfriend. No, see that? First boyfriend would probably been your husband if you stuck with him, right? But there's some things that went on, glory to God, that he couldn't be your husband. You know why? Because God had Brother Thomas waiting on you. See? But here you is. Go ahead and walk on. Go on. You see, you carrying all this burden from your past, and you can't get ahead in your new relationship because you stuck. See? And God just told you clearly, go on, walk on. I don't want you being there. Remember not the former things of old. Because if you ever let it go, watch this. He going to let you go.
Amen.
God is going to bring you out of that situation, but you can't control your narrative because you never stay stuck on page 12. And God said there's 100 pages to this book.
My God.
What does the text say?
Remember ye not the former things.
Remember ye not. You better write that down.
Amen.
The former things.
The old things, Felicia. Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. What does it say?
Neither consider.
Wait a minute. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Remember not.
Remember not.
Your past.
Your past.
Neither what?
Nor neither consider.
Wait a minute. The things of old. God is a powerful.
Yes, he is.
Neither consider even going, how can you sit up there and debate when this nigga on one upside your head 20 times?
Oh, my God.
And, I ain't going to do it no more. Mm. But brother, you shouldn't have did it the first time.
Amen.
See? If a man want to lay hands on you, something wrong.
Amen.
When you get to arguing, fussing, and cussing in your relationship, or you got to touch somebody, that means that man has run out of ideas on how to solve the problem. So now your narrative consists of abuse.
Oh God.
Who am I talking to? See? But now, God brought you out. Mm-hmm. You got a testimony in order to tell another woman, don't go there. Mm-hmm. God allowed you to get your head beat in for somebody else.
Amen.
Somebody say, I've been the sacrificial lamb.
I've been the sacrificial lamb.
Oh, Jesus.
But don't be a sacrificial fool.
My God.
That's it.
It's two people I don't argue with. A fool and somebody no more than me.
Amen.
You're not going to win that.
That's right.
Say amen.
Amen.
I'm talking about control
the narrative.
Your narrative. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
What does the text say?
Remember ye not the...
Remember ye not.
Mm-hmm. Neither consider...
Remember not the latter things. Mm-hmm. What was or how she treated me or how he did me. Because God is giving you something new, Janice. He's giving you something new.
Mm-hmm.
What? He'll give you perfect peace.
Yes, amen.
If you keep your mind...
Stayed on him.
God give us the answers to the test, but we don't study for the
test. Mm. Study shots.
Because we want to write our own narrative.
Lord Jesus.
Not realizing that he's a director.
Yes, he is.
Have I got a witness?
Amen.
What does the text say?
Neither consider the things of old.
Neither consider the things of old, that bad marriage, that heartache, the negative family members. Watch this. So you don't be surprised, glory to God, if your growth makes your circle small. Good God, who am I talking to today? Let me say it again. So don't be surprised, Janice, if your growth in ministry, if you will, Sade, your growth in ministry, Candace, makes your circle small because because of what you've been through, and now God is changing your spiritual garments. God is changing your friends, even your family members. I always tell y'all, y'all my family. My blood family, my mother's side, they ignorant. They don't deal with me. Why? Because when I chose this microphone, I came on God's side. Now it's my blood is sticking to water. That's a lie. I got some other blood. It's called the blood of Jesus. Come on, he's my armor. He's my light. He's my salvation. He's my rock. Come on and say amen. I'm talking about you got to control
the narrative.
Yes, Lord.
Your narrative.
There you go.
Opposition.
Transition.
Position.
Push you in. Position.
I call hell to opposition.
Okay.
I heard God's voice say move. I moved. And when I moved, it put me in position.
Yes,
Lord. I'm talking to somebody today. Show me who it is, God. Hallelujah. I tell you what. Your past, glory to God. You have to tell your past. I'm going to say it again. You have to tell your past. Oh, let me help somebody, including myself. You need to heal that broken child inside of you so that healthy adult can grow.
My God.
Preach, Bishop.
Come on.
Preach
it, Bishop, right there.
You got to get rid of that, what they did.
Yeah.
So that grown person can mature.
Oh, God.
Raise your hand if I'm talking to you.
Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
I'm talking about controlling your narrative because somebody is getting ready to be made free. You have to change, glory to God, so you can control your future. Come on. Control your narrative. According to Romans 8:28. And we know that all things, good God Almighty, all things work together for the good of them what? Called according to a better son, according to his what?
His purpose.
His what?
His purpose.
And watch this. God promised that all things are going to work. So when they write you off, Sister Tammy, brother Thomas, when they write you off, Janice, when they write you off, Alicia, I want you to remember who's holding the pen. Put your pen in the air. Waving like you just don't care. So when they write you off, say you'll never be nothing. Ah, good God. And say that you're going to be just like your daddy. Ah, crazy Calvin. They say you'll be that cigarette sucking, home chasing, free basin, tobacco chewing, whiskey drinking, home chasing, double daddy. When they write you off, you get your pen and say, guess what? I know somebody who can rewrite my narrative. Somebody shout Jesus. Hey, glory. Come like it. I believe the Holy Ghost. Who is this Jesus? He's the author and finisher of your life. Who is this Jesus? The King of glory. Come on, who is this Jesus? The very present help in the time of trouble. Who is this Jesus? My burning bearer, my heavenly sharer. Ain't God all right? Ain't God all right? He's all heavy load shepherd.
He's a wheel in the Maracuza. He's a wheel in the somebody help me preach this. He's a wheel in the that means there's some support inside. Glory to God. Control your narrative. We have to remember, God is in control. I don't want to clear Patrick, and his word does not expire. But guess what? Man's word does. Have I got a witness? The past is gone. So, behold and look. Somebody say, here comes my future. And guess what, baby? Candy's in this a whole lot better than what you've been through. Come on and say amen. Somebody need to do a Psalm 3. But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me. The glory, the lifter of my. The lifter of my. But thou, O Lord, are the glory, the lifter of my. Come on, somebody. Who is this Jesus, the bright and morning star? Who is this Jesus, the Holy One, that will make the devil quiver and shiver? Who is this Jesus? Demons bow down.
When they hear that name,
yeah.
He's the author of my narrative.
Amen.
Say amen unto me.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Yes,
come on, who is this Jesus?
Yes, Lord.
He's the one that helps me control my narrative.
Yes,
come on, glory to God.
Amen.
He's the one that helps me. Come on, when I can't see my way out.
Glory.
Come on and say amen.
Amen.
Who is this Jesus? Look at your neighbor's neighbor.
Neighbor.
Who is this Jesus?
Who is this Jesus?
He's the one that can give you a miracle.
Yes,
stand it on our feet all over the building.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Somebody got to have a miracle.
Yes.
Somebody say, who is this Jesus?
Yes.
Somebody say, I'm going to control my narrative.
Yes.
I'm going to control my narrative. From this day forth, God is the director, but I'm going to control my narrative. Come on, how many are going to lift those hands? I'm going to control my narrative. Hallelujah, Jesus. Listen. Listen. The devil can't control your narrative. Only you can write your script. Say amen. And at the end of the day, your narrative, you have to become the co-director. Because God is the director. You have to be able to influence others that want to be like Jesus. I want you to remember these three things. Organize your narrative. Possess your narrative. And most important, do a Proverbs chapter 3. Trust in the Lord with
all thy heart.
And lean not to your
own understanding.
And all acknowledge
him.
And guess what he'll do?
Direct thy path.
That means control your narrative. How many believe that today? Time for your miracle. Time for your miracle. Somebody said, I'm not going back. To what world?
To what world?
I'm moving ahead. And I'm pushing towards the high.
Towards the high.
Somebody got to have a miracle. Somebody got to have a miracle. Come on. Say, Lord, I need a miracle. Say, Lord, this country needs a miracle. This nation needs a miracle. Say, Lord, let me be the light that shines out of darkness. That I may lead others to you. Now since my past is gone, I got my joy back. I got my peace back. I got my joy back. I got my peace back, God. Lord, I'm living for you, God. Oh, Lord, I got everything back, God, that you promised. The devil can't do nothing. I got a miracle.
Hallelujah.
Come on, worship.
Somebody say obedience.
Obedience
is better than sacrifice.
Better than sacrifice.
God spoke to me yesterday. He said, sow a seed in your life.
My God.
I told my wife as I was sitting there, I said, the Lord told me, sow a seed in my life. I obey God. This is why I'm blessed. This is why the enemy can't touch me. Because when I hear him, I move quick. That's why I always tell y'all, you can't hear me getting burst. Because I want my dad to know, I'm trying. I'm trying. In the name of Jesus, Father, I obeyed you, and I sow the seed, God, for my grandchildren, my children, my home, my future, this church future. In the name of Jesus, I decree a miracle in this woman's life. And I ask you to multiply this seed 10 times. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody gonna have a miracle. Somebody got to have a miracle. Glory to God. Glory to God. How many love him? I said, how many love him? It's your time. It's your time. Somebody says, it's my time.
It's my time.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
God, I got the victory.
I want us to worship God for just a moment. We talked about one sound. Everybody say one sound.
Somebody say one sound.
There is a kingdom sound. There is a kingdom sound. Everybody say that. There is a kingdom sound. Say it again. There is a kingdom sound. I want you to understand this, that there is always a sound that precedes a move of God.
Yeah.
Everybody say that. There's always a sound.
There's always a sound
that precedes.
That proceeds. Come on, lift those hands.
Whenever you will find,
say, God, that's me.
Deliverance.
Say, God, I'm delivered.
Wherever you find,
say, Lord, when I walk out this door, I'm not going to be the same. Come on, listen to me. Somebody got an anger spirit on them right now. I bind this anger spirit. If that be you, got an anger spirit, come on right here. Come on. Come on, somebody. Because I'm talking to myself. Come on. It's in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Father,
in the name of Jesus.
Come on, everybody.
Come against this past, God, that wants to fight our mind, God. Lord, she serves you. We decree and declare a miracle right now. In the name of Jesus, even the restless nights. She just wants peace. I'm going to tell you this, woman. You don't want to hear this, but you're going to preach like a mad woman. I see fire coming out of your mouth. God is going to use you. I hear the word prophetess. I say, I hear the word prophetess. Gonna be
Jesus.
I don't know if you looked at it yet, but there's a kid ready to be another position in the school arena. And I don't know if you want to apply to be an assistant principal, something like a job coach type thing, but when it opens, apply. Glory to God. You should be further than what you are. You should be further financially, in your position, your woman of intellect. But it's like the devil kind of held you back a little bit, but God allowed you to do it. Because you'll be able to testify and tell others how to go around the storm instead of going through a storm that they shouldn't have to go through. Does that make sense? Somebody said, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.